So now we are moving into the panel three, the ToMMo details. The four speakers will present the details of ToMMo. And the first speaker is Naoko Minegishi, the professor taking care of the biobank of ToMMo. And Naoko is going to talk about ToMMo biobank system for ensuring the quality and accuracy of biospecimens. Naoko, are you ready?
Thank you, Chairman.
Okay, please.
I'm very much happy to talk today on our biobank management system. So today, at first, I will introduce shortly on our biobank and then give the presentation on our management system. We collect biospecimens obtained from prospective cohort studies in the tsunami-devastated areas. The aim of ToMMo project is primarily to clarify the risk of diseases and health problems after disaster, and the second, to facilitate stratified medicine and healthcare in this stricken region. So we are performing the population cohort study in Miyagi Prefecture and in the Pacific coast of Iwate Prefecture. Specimen and health information collected in this study is as follows. 34 milliliters of blood are collected from standard participant, and 13 millimeter of blood are for laboratory tests, which results return to participants and stored as a data of a biobank. The remaining 21 milliliter of blood, plasma, buffy coat, serum and mononuclear cells, and urine are stored in biobank. Mothers in three generation cohorts donate three times blood and breast milk. We also collect cold blood and saliva from children. Questionnaire using our cohort study is almost all consistent with the Japanese cohort standard, and we can use these data with sharing with other population cohort studies in Japan. We added some disaster-related questions and ABO blood type question. Parts of participants have the additional physical examination and then MRI. Now we have collected more than 1 million tubes specimens obtained from more than 71,000 participants. We extracted DNA from more than 24,000 participants. And about quarter is from Iwate Prefecture, and another quarter from three generation cohort, and the remaining half is from Miyagi population cohorts. Our storage system can store about 5.7 million 1 millimeter 2D matrix tubes. And in that, the 1.3 million at minus 18 or 180 and 119 centigrade in vapor phase liquid nitrogen containers, and others are in osmotic storage system, 900,000 at 4 degree and 3.5 million at minus 8 degree. This is a summary of our biobank. We collect samples from two cohort studies. We performing whole genome analysis and omics analysis. And we have some storage and ICT and use for the expected researches. Then I introduce our laboratory information management system. Our system only use the identified specimens and their preparation, storage, and DNA extraction. This is independent from cohort information system and analytical platform, and closed, and this is closed system. We have a backup on supercomputer and the integrated database explained afterwards in by Ogishima sensei. The backup data can used by integrated database as a specimen data. So here shows the sample preparation protocols. We use REMUS all process in biobank. REMUS is very much helpful for manual preparation of paper wrap mononuclear cells. This is top page of our REMUS system. REMUS green line shows the line of mononuclear cell manual procedures. This procedure uses four different types of sample tubes. The blood cells, the blood cells moves to 1, 2, 3, 4 tubes. So to avoid errors when we move the blood or cells from left to right tubes, we check the ID barcode using REMUS. Then check that this is okay. Then we proceed to next steps. Then at that point, we also do the same procedures. The critical step in mononuclear cell preparation is a parent-child pairing system steps. So workers dispense from this tube to the barcode tube and read the barcode in this field. But sometimes worker omits to press button. So some orphan 2D tubes were found in our REMUS system. So it is a problem. We can correct this by DNA information, but it is a problem. So we updated the check system. Added the check system in the REMUS to verify. We read that barcode, then display the registered child specimens. After this update, no errors were reported in this procedure. Then at the end of the day, we check the progress of daily work, but we also use paper checklist to avoid the leaving specimens in centrifuge or safe cabinet or so. We also use the REMUS system to monitor temperature of cool box and refrigerator and time recording for traceability. Our standard procedure, we freeze samples within the day of reception. In proteomics study by omics team or our ToMMo project, the specimen left for more than 12 hours could not produce the adequate results. In addition, in metabolomic study, both in NMR and mass spectrometry, specimens must be kept refrigerated before centrifuge and freeze at -80 centigrade to get sufficient results. That is very clear. So we receive biospecimen after samples are collected in the health checkup site, hospital, and center and satellite. So then biospecimens are transferred to Tohoku University in cool box with temperature logo. Usual samples we receive within 8 hours and process and freeze within a day. But we also receive the specimen at the next day or more from blood collection. We have the records of temperature and the time records in DIMS. We and the researchers can select and specimens for suitable for proteomics and metabolomics analysis. It's a DIMS power. And the tracking time records is also helpful to identify the error procedures. So as an example, in gender matching test, we view the ID errors in collection of RE 2013 in one DNA extraction. So tracking data identified this yellow cells are the same DNA extraction, but these are not the same. And these three is not an error, but this yellow cells have a DNA extraction in one preparation. So we identified that the DNA extraction steps are error steps, and we found additional errors in the same run of DNA extraction that can be identified by the gender mismatching. So the laboratory automation and REMUS further reduce errors. Automatic dispenser read barcode 1D and 2D and calculate volume of dispense, detect levels buff equal by laser detection, and measure and adjust DNA concentration OD by OD and fluorescence, and dispense and register parent-child relationship, this and this. So, and the data of automatic dispenser are imported into REMUS, which shows the status of each specimen. This rack and this position contains this barcode specimen. We also equipped automatic storage system, which can cherry pick at -80. This shows the camera in the store. And DIMS and storage system are seamlessly linked to the same desktop PCs. We also equipped automated DNA extraction system. DNA yielded 42.4 microgram, and more than 99% of specimens have over 10 microgram yield, so then 99.7% have a specific result in whole genome sequences. And the very good and the very good quality of DNA extracted from automated system. Then I show our trial to check ID integrity in our biobank. But how much are the error rates reported in other biobanks? I search for the PubMed and the Google Scholar of the word biobank and error, but only hits only several papers. One is UK Biobank Protocol that estimates 1% error rate in that protocol. The other is Vanderbilt University at 2008 that shows 0.26% of gender mismatch between electrolyte glucose and gel type. These two papers only show the genetic discrepancy of mother and child and father and child. Therefore, the rate did not exactly reflect the error rate of their biobank. So very, very few data on error rate. So we have a data that we found that 26 gender mismatch cases are reported in our biobank specimen, 10,000 specimen with SNPs data, with between cohort and SNPs data. But 11 is no handling errors were detected by STR analysis, and we identified 15 of 26 ID handling errors. This is 0.15 in 10,000 cases. So I think our error rate in ToMMo Biobank is acceptable, not so high as a population-based biobank, but we must minimize error rate. So our plan is it detect ID errors, error-prone procedures, so, and the construct ID check flow through cohort biobank and genome data. We have already found error-prone procedures described before. I say before that in the DNA extraction and pre-DNA extraction to the tube to input tube and after output tube to 2D tube. So 100 errors occurred in 2013. So we update the WIMS and one by one check. And we are equipped with the automatic system in this robotic, in this stage. So, but for checking integrity of ID management in pre-biobank, because we in our situation, the cohort study and post-biobank and genetic analysis. DNA analysis, STR, SNPs, and sequencing can detect ID errors in biobank and in post-biobank steps and genomic genome analysis. But it is difficult to find the cohort information errors, pre-biobank errors. So DNA analysis plus some cohort information are required to detect the pre-biobank errors. So one is the gender mismatch, male or female, but the sensitivity of this mismatch method is maybe 50%. And specificity is high, but not 100%, because in some participant calls, I am a male but have a woman's name. So maybe some miss in the participant. So not 100%. So we think that in Japanese, ABO blood type, A 40%, B 20%, O 30%, and AB 10%. So very proportional. And Japanese know their own ABO blood type because women having the experience of pregnancy knew their ABO blood type by in the maternity check. And blood donation, maybe 4.4 or 5% of population each year in Japan, also know their blood type correctly. And other persons also know their ABO blood type. Maybe in questionnaire in cohort study, we ask ABO blood type questions. So, and the other reason is ABO blood type can be also used for checking the ID management of serum and plasma samples because anti-A, anti-B antibody can be detected in the serum or plasma. The expected sensitivity of error detection by gender mismatch is 50%, but gender and ABO increase 84%. So I practiced 31 ID errors in two times of DNA extraction errors. So 31 in the 16th, 52% detected by gender mismatch, but the remaining specimens cannot be detected by the gender mismatch. But sex and ABO blood type, we estimated that we could detect 84% of these errors. So gender mismatch in gender specificity, gender mismatch in their previous report in Vanderbilt University, 8 mismatch cases are found, but 7 is iatrogenic by a transfusion and transplantation. But and in our SNP cases, specificity was 58%. The ABO blood type, we calculate the discrepancy between the pregnant mothers and first and second test result of more than 5,000 cases. And 0.4% have the discrepancy between one first and second test results. So the specificity is not 100%. And gene variations, the ABO blood type can be identified but can be identified in whole genome sequences, but only estimated by in the SNP arrays by the neighboring SNPs. And over 90% of participants know their ABO blood type, but occasionally occasionally their memory may be incorrect. So he called A, but actually he's B. So to flow to check ID errors, the participant, the cohort data, in the cohort data, we gather the gender and ABO information. And if the samples, specimens are delivered to the analysis, and genomic data from whole genome sequencing or SNPs array or so, the sex and ABO as gathered. And we also done the ABO blood type, RBC type in DIMS. So this and this and this are matching. And if matching, it's okay, but if different, the second step. In preliminary, in 4,048 cases that that have these data, 0.98% have the mismatch in cohort questionnaire, but equal ABO blood type in SNPs and RBC. And in RBC type in mismatch, 0.18%. That is lower than the mismatch discrepancy rate in 0.4 on two times from same participant. So it is acceptable. And also we have a data on SNPs of discrepancy, that is 0.6%, but it is only the SNPs, estimated data from SNPs, so maybe the discrepancy rate is lower than 0.6%. Then the next step, but it the difference. So we have a reserve to buffer code tubes is stored in our freezer. So we reextracted DNA from this sample and compare the SDR and SNPs results or qPCR result or sex ABO, determine whether we have an error in these steps or we our procedures are correct, but maybe some cohort data or some maybe some genomic data are different. So last is the access and delivery only showed. So we will start the data access and sample usage within 2015. The character of our delivery is judging criteria of in access application. We added the point that the research contribute to human society, especially people affected by the Great East Japan earthquake. It is important to our judging criteria. And the other question is whether is it important for our biobank long-term storage, expecting the result like Framingham study or other cohort studies, or prompt delivery for present research activities. It is very much a question for us. So this is a summary of our biobank management system. Our biobank stored more than 1 million specimens from more than 70,000 participants. And we equipped RIMS and laboratory automation to keep quality and traceability of specimens. These systems are useful to identify and update error-prone procedures. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Naoko, the precise presentation. And now this presentation is open for discussion. Any question or comments, please? So Naoko, before waiting the question, in 2013, we had a one accident, and you are calculating that one. You put that accident into the number of the errors. But what will happen if you exclude that and start from the calculation from 2014? What is our error ratio?
But we haven't.
We haven't.
Not so much genomic analysis data in 2014 specimens. So
okay. If we can accumulate the genomic analysis of the 2014, then you can calculate the ratio of the 2014. I see. Okay. Any other questions or comments? Okay. Thank you very much.